He never claimed to be divine, but his death stunned so many. News 4's Steve Dunlop reports.
On the doorstep of their headquarters, they prayed, taking solace in their God and in their ritual. When the door opened to the Rebbe's room, they surged forward, pushing and shoving like an F train at rush hour, but not saying a word. To the Rebbe's gravesite in Queens, they also came, paying tribute to a man they loved like a father. Those from out of town were easy to identify. They had the carry-on luggage. Most boarded a plane as soon as they could.
Since I'm only here for one day, I'm not really staying at anywhere particular. I'm just in 770 itself.
You left so quickly you had no time to make arrangements of any kind.
That's right.
This man was in Paris when he learned of the Rebbe's death. He spent 6,000 francs, about $1,100, for a seat on the Concorde.
You had to get here very quickly.
Oui, vraiment.
They all agreed that the Rebbe was a great man, a great teacher. But even the most devoted followers were divided over the claim that Menachem Schneerson was the Moshiach, or the Messiah. Do you believe the Rebbe was the Messiah?
Definitely. There's no question that all the criteria that Maimonides writes of the Messiah he had.
Was he the Messiah to you?
No, he was not. A Messiah has to be a living person. He just inspired us to put us on the right path to bring the Messiah. And for all I know is right now, he might be standing in front of what we call the Bezdin Shemayim, demanding that God bring the Messiah right now.
For now at least, the Lubavitcher movement will be run by the same council of rabbis that has governed the sect since the Rebbe's first disabling stroke in 1992. Any successor, and those here hesitate to use the word successor, can emerge only on the strength of his teaching, and even then, only by consensus. You get the sense that that's not ready to happen here just yet, and may not be until the grieving starts to stop. Steve Dunlop, News 4, Crown Heights.